Hello children, today we are going to solve value based questions from the chapter Squares and Square Roots. The first question, Priya wants to wish her teacher on Teacher's Day by giving her a self-made greeting card. She chooses a pink colored square sheet of paper. A side of that paper measures 19.5 centimeter. So here Priya, a girl, wants to make a greeting card to her teacher on account of Teacher's Day. So she chooses pink colored square sheet of paper, and this square sheet of paper means the side of a paper measures 19.5 centimeter. Here two sub questions are asked. One is, find the area of paper she chooses for the card. The second sub question is, what act of Priya did you like? So here the dimension of the paper she chooses is square sheet, and whose measure is 19.5 centimeter, and he is asking to find its area. So side is equal to 19.5 centimeter. We know that area of square equal to S into S. Then 19.5 into 19.5. So the product of it is 380.25 centimeter square, because he asked area, therefore you will get square centimeter. So now moving towards the B question, that is, what act of Priya did you like here? So we can write respect or gratitude and thankful nature. So the first, respect towards the teacher, gratitude towards the teacher, and you can say thankful nature. Now we'll move to second question of value based. The students of class 8th B of a school donated 2,304 rupees for the Prime Minister's National Relief Fund. Each student donated as many rupees as the number of students in the class. Suppose if there are X students in a class, then each child donated the amount is rupees X only, because according to the question. In this, two sub questions are asked. One is, find the number of students in class 8th B, and second is, what quality of the students do you appreciate here? So let us solve this. Let the number of students in class 8th B be X students. So according to question, then amount donated by each child or each student is rupees X only, because according to the condition in the question, each student donated as many rupees as the number of students in the class. So total amount equal to 2,304. So if there are X students and each child donated X amount is nothing but total amount. So X into X is nothing but X square equal to 2,304. Then X equal to square root of 2,304. So we need to find its value by the long division method. 2,304. Then we'll get two periods. 5 5s are 25 becomes greater. So I'll go for 4. 4 4s are 16. Then remains is 7. Add up 4. We'll get 8. Take the next number 0 4. Since it is ending with 4, means it should be 2 in the ones place or 8 in the ones place. 2 2s are 4. 2 8s are 16 smaller. So I'll go with 8. 88 into 8. 8 8 64. 8 8 64 plus 6. 64 plus 6 70. then which is equal to the dividend year. So 8's are 704 and the remainder is 0, means 48 is the answer. It's nothing but there were 48 students in class 8th B and each child donated is rupees 48. But you write down what he asked in the question. That is, find the number of students. Therefore, number of students in class 8th B are 48 students. And next question is, what quality of the students do you appreciate here? So the quality can be written like this, that is, the students exhibit responsibility and duty towards the nation. The students exhibit responsibility and duty towards the nation. So this completes value based question, children. Now let me move to brain teasers. So under that first question, A main, tick the correct option. Under that first question, the difference between the squares of two consecutive numbers is equal to their dash. Here the options given are sum, difference, product and quotient. But whenever we are finding the difference between the squares of two consecutive numbers, we always add their base. So I can write it as sum. Just tick in your option. The sum is in second option. Next, second one, what will be the digit in thousands place of 1111 square? We know that 1111 square is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4 and 3, 2, 1, which we learnt in facts, right? And here he is asking what will be the digit in the thousands place. So ones, tens, hundred, thousand. So digit 4 will be in the thousands place. So if I want to go with the options, then B option is your answer. So let me move to third question. Perfect squares cannot have 2, 3, dash and dash in its ones digit. So according to the facts, so 2, 3, 7, 8. If the number ends with 2, 3, 7, 8 in the ones place, then the number is not a perfect squares. Fourth question, the smallest number by which 72 must be divided to make it into a perfect square is dash. So what is that smallest number which must be divided to 72 to make it into a perfect square? We know that to find the number multiplied or divided, we need to go with the prime factorization. Since it is ending with the 2, I'll go with the 2. So 2 3s are 6, 2 6 are 12. Then 2 1s are, 2 8s are, 2 9s are, 3 3s are, 3 1s are. So here these 3 and these 2 are in pairs, but here this 2 is not in pair. Therefore, it must be divided by 2 to make it into a perfect square. Next, the square root of 3.052009 has dash decimal places. As we know that before decimal point, it is the whole number part, should make a period from right number to the left, and after the decimal point, which we call it as decimal part, we have to make the periods from left to right. So two digits makes one pair, the another one pair, the next one pair. So after decimal point, we have how many decimals do we get for the square root of this number? So 3, because we have here 3 periods. So 3 decimal places. Now let me move to B main. Answer the following question in that sub question 1. How many non-square numbers are there between 13 square and 14 square? We know that 13 and 14 are the two consecutive numbers and its square is given, and we need to find the non-square numbers between. So we know in formula, that is if n square and n plus 1 square is there, then we have a 2n non-square numbers, right? So which is nothing but 2 into the smallest number is 13. So 13, 13 to the 26, 26 non-square numbers lie between 13 square and 14 square. So now let me move to second question. Write the first four triangular numbers. So the triangular numbers we have discussed in first day class. So we know that the triangular numbers are first four triangular numbers are 1, 3, 6 and 10. Next, third sub question. Is 579 a Pythagorean triplets? Why and justify? So by looking into the numbers only we can say 579 are not Pythagorean triplets. If you do not know, first you can justify and then you can give the conclusion. We know that hypotenuse is the longest square, longest side. So 9 square equal to 5 square plus 7 square, that is hypotenuse square equal to base square plus perpendicular square, which we learned in class 7 standard. 9 square is 81, 5 square is 25 and 7 square is 49. Then 81 equal to 9 plus 5 is 14, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I can say that 81 is not equal to 74. That is, does not satisfies, Pythagoras theorem. Fourth question, find square root 9 by repeated subtraction method. So the repeated subtraction method can be found only by using odd numbers. So 9 minus 1 equal to 8 and 8 minus, after 1 the next odd number is 3. So 8 minus 3 is 5 and 5, next odd number after 3 is 5, 5 minus 5 equal to 0. So 0 is obtained in, 0 is obtained in third step. Therefore, square root of 9 equal to 3. We know that root 9 equal to 3, but it should be shown by repeated subtraction method. Now let me move to fifth question. Find the measure of the side of a square handkerchief of area 324 centimeters square. So here the handkerchief is given, but it is in the form of square shaped. So we know that area of square equal to side into side. So side into side equal to 324 according to the question. Then S square equal to 324 and S equal to square root of 324. We know that 324 is a perfect square of 18. So square and root get cancels, then S equal to 18 centimeter. And here conclusion should be given, side of a square handkerchief. So side of square handkerchief is 18 centimeter. So this completes first question from the brain teasers. Now let me move to second question. Find the square root of 10 correct to 4 places of decimal. So here 10 is non-perfect square and we have to find its root till 4 places of decimal, means we need to find till 5th place of decimal and then round off to 4th place of decimal. So here 10 is a whole number, can be written in the form of decimal, that is 10.00000000, because he is asking till 4 places, we need to find till 5 places. So before decimal point, whole number part, from right to left making the pairs, and after a decimal point from left to right making the pairs, means 5 decimal place means there should be a 10 digit number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 places of digit we have here. And the first period is 10. 10. So nearest to 2 perfect square, nearest to 10 is 9. So 3 square is 9. 3 threes are 9. And the subtraction is 1. And add up the same number in the divisor. So 6. So when we are moving to the decimal part of number, then we need to make a point in the quotient and bring the 00 down. So 61 ones are is 61. Then 10 minus 1 is 9. Here 9, 9 minus 6 is 3. Add the same digit whatever we have taken in the divisor. So 61 plus 1 is 62. Bring the next period. 00. It becomes 3900 and it becomes 600 place. 6 is in hundreds place. So 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s 24, 6 5s 30, 6 6 36. So let us check 6 26 into 6. So it is nearer only. 6 will get 3756. Then subtraction, 10 minus 6 is 4. 9 minus 5 is 4, then 8, 8 minus 7 is 1, add up the same digit, 6, then 6 plus 6 is 12, then 2 plus 1 is 3 and 6, bring the next period down, 0, 0. So 3za becomes greater, so I'll go for 2za, 2 2 is 4, 2 2 is 4, 2 3 is 6, then 6 2 is 12, then subtraction. 10 minus 4 is 6, 9 minus 4 is 5, then 13, 13 minus 6 is 7, then 3, 3 minus 2 is 1. Add up the same digit, then we'll get 6, 3, 2, 4 and bring the next period down, 0, 0. Again, I hope so, 2 is nearer, 2's are 2, 2's are 4, then 2, 4's are 8, 2, 2's are 4, then 2 3s are 6, then 2 6 are 12. Then subtract, 10 minus 4 is 6, 9 minus 8 is 1, then here 5, 5 minus 4 is 1, then 15 minus 6 is 9, then 6 remains, 6 minus 2 is 4. Then add up the same, you will get 6 3 2 4 4. Bring the next period down. If I go with 7za, it will be nearer to it. So we'll get 4 4 2 7 1 2 9. If I go for subtraction with this, then I'll get 4 8 double 4 7 1. So this is the remainder. Then square root of 10 equal to 3.16227. Since he is asking to round off to 4th decimal place, clear. Then we have to round off and check what is there in the 5th decimal place. It is 7, which is greater than 5. So I can add plus 1 to the 4th decimal place. So 3.1623. Correct to 4th decimal place. Now let me move to 3rd question. Find the values of square root of 3.1428 and square root of 0.31428 correct to 3 decimal places. As we have done in question 2, the same way in question 3 also we need to find till 3rd decimal place, in the sense till 4th decimal place we need to find and then round off to 3rd decimal place. So first let me take this number, that is square root of 3.1428. Then start making the periods in whole number from right to left, in decimal part from left to right. If you want the next double zero, because he is asking 3rd decimal place. Here we have only 2 periods. Means we need to find till 4th decimal place, in the sense 4 periods. So now I got 3 periods. The another 2 zero makes 4th period. Then normal division, I mean long division, we need to follow. Clear? So 3, the perfect square near to 3 is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. And the remainder is 2. Add up 1. Then you will get 2. Then here we are moving to the decimal part. So make a point in the quotient and bring the divisor. So as usual. So here I have done for you 1.7727 is the quotient. And he is asking to round off to third decimal place. So we have to look after the digit in the fourth decimal place. Then we will get it. Answer as 1.77. So fourth decimal place is greater than 5. So plus 1. So 3. So correct 2. Correct 2. Third decimal place. Clear? So here I can write 1.773. Then moving towards the next decimal, that is square root of 0.31428. So 0.31428. The same way here also we have to do, before 0, then after decimal point from left to right. So here one digit is remaining. So another digit, make it as 0, then it becomes 3rd period, 4th period and 5th period. Now we'll go for division. So here he asked only 3 decimal place, children. No need to find the 5th decimal place till 4th decimal place, as we have done in the previous one. So here the quotient is 0.5606. So rounding off to 3rd decimal place, we need to see the digit in the 4th decimal place. We'll get the answer as 0.56, then plus 1 in the 3rd. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So the answer is 0.561. So this is up to correct 2, correct 2, 3rd place of decimal. So now let me move to 4th question. So simplify, first one, square root of 0.0441 by square root of 0.000441. Second one is root 49 plus root 0.49 plus square root of 0.0049. So after obtaining the decimal, we need to add the numbers. Okay. And here after obtaining the numbers, we need to go for division. So let me go for solution finding. So here for this, you go for long division to find its answer in both numerator and also in the denominator. So after doing, for this I got the answer as 0.21 and for this I got 0.021. So write it in the numerator and denominator, that is 0.21 divided by 0.021, convert into rational number 21 by 100, that is 0.21 can be written as 21 by 100. This division changes into multiplication reciprocal, that is 1000 divided by 21. 21, 21 get cancels. 1, 0, 1, 0, that is second 0 also get cancels. The answer is 10. The other way also you can do it, children, here. This 0.21 can be written as 21 by 100. And this division, put the division symbol as it is. And 0.021 can be written as 21 by 1000. Then division changes to in multiplication. Then reciprocal of the second fraction. After simplifying, you'll get the answer as 10 only. So for the second question, children, I'll go for direct here. You can solve it by using long division. So 49, square root 49, we know that 7 square is 49 plus, and since after decimal point we have 1 period, and that 1 period is also a perfect square, and before we have a 0, so we'll get the answer as 0.7 whole square. And for the third, 49 only the value is, but it is having after decimal point we have 2 periods, so 0.07 whole square. Then square and root get cancelled, square and root get cancelled, square and root get cancelled. Then we'll get 7 plus 0.7 plus 0.07. Then the final answer is 7.77. Be careful while adding the decimal number, children. Most of the children go wrong here itself. Clear? So be careful. In this, children, second question, third question and fourth question are very, very important for the examination. So prepare well these questions, children. So this ends today's class. Thank you. Thank you, children. Have a nice day. Thank you.